Bend and stretch, reach for the stars. There goes Jupiter, there goes Mars. Bend and stretch. Oh, hi boys and girls, it's Miss Elaine. I was just stretching before story time started. Welcome to Miss Elaine's Book Nook. I'm glad you're joining me today. So what do you think story time's about today, boys and girls? Use the stars as your first clue. Take a look at the books that I have set over here on my table. And then look over here at the rocket ships. What do you think story time's about? Did you say outer space? Right you are. And this story time is dedicated to my friend Sam. First, let's start with our welcome song. It goes like this. Welcome, welcome everyone. Now you're here, let's have some fun. First, we'll clap our hands just so. Then we'll bend and touch our toes. Welcome, welcome, everyone. Now you're here, let's have some fun. Put up your twinkle stars. Wiggle your 10 little fingers and pretend they're twinkle stars in the nighttime sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Very good. Let's sing that one more time, but this time you can sing along to a video.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you
are. So our first book is going to be about the biggest star in the sky. Do you know what the biggest star in the sky is? It's the sun. This book is called The Sun is My Favorite Star. It's by Frank Ashe. The sun is my favorite star. In the morning, it comes to my window and wakes me up. It says, rise and shine. While I have breakfast, it sends the mist away and dries up the morning dew. Then it waits for me to come out and play. The sun is my favorite star. Do you like to go outside and play in the sun? Yeah, and the sun is starting to shine more and more these days. So it's a great fun to go to the park, to play out in your yard. Gliding through the trees above my head, it follows me everywhere I go. Its light is bright and hot. That's why when the sun shines a lot in the summertime, we want to cool off in the pool, don't we? Or run through the sprinkler, because the sun can be really hot. It peeks through a hole in the fence. It casts my shadow on the wall. The sun is my favorite star. Sometimes it plays hide and seek with me. Where is it hiding? You can see its rays still shining down. Yeah, it's hiding behind the cloud. Sometimes it goes away and we have a rainfall. And it brings me back a big bouquet. It rains and then the sun comes out again to shine. Sometimes what we see in the sky is a beautiful thing called what? Called a rainbow. Absolutely. The sun is my favorite star. In the evening, it paints pretty pictures in the sky for me. Have you ever seen a sunset in the evening? Very pretty. Sometimes it's a deep red, sometimes it looks purplish. Even in the night, it sends some light to keep me company. All stars in the sky are beautiful, but so far, the sun is my, what? My favorite star. The sun is my favorite star too. Is it yours? Yeah? Well, this book reminds me of a sunshine song that our purple dinosaur friend sings. Do you know who I'm talking about? Barney. Watch as Barney sings, "Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun."
Sun!
Oh, yay!
Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me.
Yes,
oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree.
Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me.
Oh, yeah!
Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me.
Yes,
oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree.
Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on, please shine down on, please shine down on me.
Welcome back, boys and girls. Our second book is by the same author. It's by Mr. Frank Ash. And this one is called Happy Birthday, Moon. One night, Bear looked up at the sky and thought, "Wouldn't it be nice to give the moon a birthday present?" But Bear didn't know when the moon's birthday was or what to get him. So he climbed a tall tree to have a little chat with the moon. "Hello, moon," he shouted. But the moon did not reply. "Maybe I'm too far away," thought Bear, "and the moon cannot hear me." So Bear paddled across the river and hiked through the forest into the mountains. Now I am much closer to the moon, thought Bear, and he again shouted, "Hello!" This time his own voice echoed off one of the other mountains. "Hello!" Bear got very excited. "Oh boy," he thought, "I'm talking to the moon." "Tell me," asked Bear, "when is your birthday?" "Tell me, when is your birthday?" replied the moon. "Well, it just so happens that my birthday is tomorrow," said Bear. "Well, it just so happens that my birthday is tomorrow," said the moon. "What do you want for your birthday?" asked Bear. "What do you want for your birthday?" asked the moon. Bear thought for a moment, and then he replied, "I would like a hat." "I would like a hat," said the moon. "Oh, goody," thought Bear. "Now I know what to get the moon for his birthday." "Goodbye," said Bear. "Goodbye," said Moon. When Bear got home, he dumped all the money out of his piggy bank. He's going to go buy the moon a hat. Is the moon really talking back to Bear? No. It's Bear's own echo, isn't it? Well, then Bear went downtown and he bought the moon a beautiful hat. That night, he put the hat up in a tree where the moon could find it. And then he waited and watched while the moon slowly crept through the branches and tried on the hat. "Hooray!" yelled Bear. "It fits just right." During the night, while Bear slept, the hat fell out of the tree. In the morning, Bear found the hat on his doorstep. "So the moon got me a hat too," exclaimed Bear. He tried it on and it fit perfectly. But just then, the wind blew Bear's hat off of his head. He chased after it. Is it going to catch it? Oh, it got away. That night, Bear paddled across the river and hiked through the forest to talk with the moon. For a long time, the moon would not speak to him, so Bear spoke first. "Hello," he shouted. "Hello," replied the moon. "I lost the beautiful hat you gave me," said Bear. "I lost the beautiful hat you gave me," said the moon. "That's okay, I still love you," said Bear. "That's okay, I still love you," said the moon. "Happy birthday," said Bear. "Happy birthday," said the moon. The end. So that whole time that Bear thought he was talking to the moon, it was really his own echo. Have you ever heard your echo, boys and girls? The best time is if you're in a tunnel where there's walls all around you. Just like a ball would bounce off the wall if you threw it, so does your voice. Your sound bounces off that wall and it comes back to you. That's what an echo is. Sometimes it's hard to understand, but you'll have to practice finding your echo one day, and then you'll understand all about Happy Birthday Moon and how Bear was feeling. Well, this book reminds me of another song. It's called Moon, 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 and nobody sings it better than Laurie Berkner. Enjoy the next video.
Moon, 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 shining bright. Moon, 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 my night light. Turn it on. Chick. Moon, 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 I can see. Moon, 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 you're taking care of me. Moon, 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 shining bright. Moon, 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 my night light. Moon, 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 I can see. Moon, 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 you're taking care of me. Look up, it's the moon. Look up, it's the moon. Look up, it's the moon up in the sky. It's big and round, and I have found that it looks just like a pizza pie. Moon, 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 shining bright. Moon, 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 my night light. Moon, 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 I can see. Moon, 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 you're taking care of me. Look up, it's the moon. Look up, it's the moon. Look up, it's the moon up in the sky. It's big and round, and I have found that it looks just like a lemon pie.
All right, boys and girls, our final book is a silly one. It's about a bunny who wants to fly to outer space. So he's an astro bunny. We'll have to pretend that he has an astronaut helmet on and a space suit. What do you think? Do you really want to go to the moon, astro bunny? He's saying he does. All right, well, let's read his story. It's called Astro Bunnies by Christine Loomis. Astro bunnies see a star and think they'd like to go that far. Slip on silver suits with pockets, climb up stairs to shiny rockets. Oh, they're boarding their rocket ship. Rockets stand so straight and tall, bunnies on the ground look small. Push a button, twist a dial, rocket launches, bunnies smile. Uh-oh, they're preparing for liftoff. They're really gonna go into space. Bunnies in space, that's silly. Zip and zoom up through the sky, astro bunnies wave goodbye. You gonna wave goodbye, astro bunny? You wave to our friends at home? He's off. Whiz and whoosh, the rocket races through the deep and darkened spaces. Over Venus, under Mars, bunnies follow shooting stars. Astro bunnies unsnap straps, open hatches, ports, and flaps. Roll up, float up, through the air, stroll up, bounce up, everywhere. Astro bunnies work together, measure comets, chart the weather, gather moon dust from a crater, scientists can study later. They're even collecting some moon dust to bring back home. Ride their rockets in slow motion through a silent, starry ocean. Gliding by the Milky Way, where night is dark and so is day. Look at the bunny looking out from the rocket ship window. Then a ship appears in space, bunnies from another place. Astro bunnies love exploring, making new friends, scouting, touring. Oh, they met more bunny friends in space, maybe from another planet. Yet wherever bunnies go, there is one thing they all know. Rockets fly and rockets roam, but bunnies always come back home. And there's our bunny. Oh, he's waving to you one more time. Say bye-bye, Astro Bunny. The end. I think that was pretty silly. We're going to end with one more story on today's Book Nook. And this one is actually a flannel board story. So you see my five rockets on the board, and they look pretty smushed, don't they? But there are five. Will you help me count just to make sure? One, two, three, four, five. Five little rockets ready to zoom. And the green one says, there's not enough room. So it starts its engine, ready to fly, looks at the others, and then waves goodbye. And he takes off to the moon. And that leaves four little rockets. Four little rockets ready to zoom. The purple one says, there's not enough room. It starts its engine, gets ready to fly, looks at the others, and then waves goodbye. He takes off. That leaves how many? Three. Three little rockets ready to zoom. The blue one says, there's not enough room. It starts its engine, ready to fly, looks at the others, and then waves goodbye. Blast off. Now we only have two. Two little rockets ready to zoom. The orange one says, there's not enough room. It lights its engine, gets ready to fly, looks at the other, and then waves goodbye. See you later. That only leaves us one little rocket. One little rocket ready to zoom, looks at no one and says, there's not enough room. So it lights its engine, gets ready to fly, looks at you and waves goodbye. And there he goes. He took off to the moon too. But boys and girls, I want to show you how you can make your very own rocket at home. And you can make your rocket take off. It can blast off to the moon because you're going to learn how to make your rocket or attach your rocket to a straw. And if you give me a countdown at home, I'll show you how this one will blast off. Countdown from five. Ready? Blast off! Do you want to know how I did that? Let me show you one more time. And I'll count with you this time. Five, four, three, two, one. Blast off! There it goes. Let me show you how I did it. So to make this rocket, boys and girls, all you need to do is draw your own rocket or print one from the internet like I did. You can find these Google images online and with mom or dad's help, have them print it for you. And then you need to color your rocket. And of course, you can make your rocket any colors you wish. I'll put some orange on this one. And let's see, I think I'll make the body of the rocket blue. I like to outline when I color. Do you do that, boys and girls? Helps me stay inside the lines. If I outline that black line, my color. And you can make as many of these as you'd like. So maybe you want to make one for a friend and have your rockets race. Or maybe you have a brother or sister at home that you'd like to make one for. Now I have some of my body of my rockets down here too, remember? So I'll color in that part. There. Now I need to color my wings, and I'll do it red. Shade those in quickly. And I wonder, should I do the top of my rocket? Should I do the point of my rocket red too? Yeah, I think I will. Now this is the window of my rocket, so you might want to leave that white. Or maybe I'll color it yellow. Like there's some lights on in there. Or like it's reflecting the moon and the stars in outer space. There! Now, once you have your rocket colored, you're going to take a pair of safety scissors, of course, and you're going to want to cut your rocket out. And mom and dad might have to help with this part too, and that's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you want to try to stay around those lines. Cut out the wing, and then the body. All the way up to the point and back around. Let's cut that piece of paper off. There we go. Now the fun thing is, you get to do this twice, even if it's just for you. So if you're making one for your friend, you'll have to do it four times. You need two just for you. So you're going to want to color another rocket the same way. You're going to take one of your colored rockets, and you're going to tape a straw inside. Tape works better than glue. So I have some handy dandy Scotch tape. Two pieces is plenty. I'm going to tape that straw down right onto the back of my rocket so it looks like this, with the straw on the back. See? Now, when I have my other rocket colored, I will glue that to the back so that my rocket is two-sided, like this one that I showed you earlier. It has to be two-sided. Okay, and remember, you stuck that straw in the middle, didn't you? So the final step then is to take another straw. You can cut a little bit off if you want, or you don't have to. You're going to take another straw, and you're going to slide it up into that straw that's hiding, that one that you taped in the middle. And then you're ready for takeoff. You can give yourself a count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then blow. For blast off. Well, boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed today's story time all about outer space. I will look forward to seeing you next month when we do a story time about all things spring. Bye-bye.